الله الرحمن الرحيم الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار الله الرحمن الرحيم الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to this new episode about the beautiful names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In today's episode, we want to speak about Al-Barr, and that is number 79 in that order which we have followed right from the beginning. The word Al-Barr, which means the righteous, it is coming from Al-Birr. Al-Birr, which is the righteousness, the good act. So, Al-Barr and also Al-Barr means the person with the righteousness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the source of all the gifts, all what is needed by the man, all what is needed by all the creatures. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Barr, providing them what they need for their existence in this world. Allah, who keeps on giving them, even there are people who disobey Him, even there are sins committed on that earth which is created by Allah, still He gives them what they need. In this manner, we can say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His birr, His gift, His generosity does not come to an end. There is another meaning of the word birr. For example, it is used in Arabic language that someone abarra bi qasamih, or abarra Allahu bi qasamih. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled that oath which a person has taken. In one of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, our Prophet has said, "Rubba ash'asa akbar ذي طمرين لا يؤبه لها لا يؤبه له لو أقسم على الله لأبره." There may be a person with hair scattered, feet dusty, wearing very old two mantles. Nobody got any care for him. The person is neglected by all. But he is so beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of his piety, because of his good action, that if he says about anything by taking an oath in the name of Allah, Allah is going to fulfill for him that thing on which he has taken an oath. So this is another meaning of the word barra or abarra, which means to accept or to respond. And there is another variation, you can say, of the meaning. That is to be true in your saying, in your utterance, in your deeds. For example, they say, barrat yaminuhu ay sadaqat. Someone has taken an oath and he was true to his oath. That is what is meant also by that word. And we can say, for such people, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ نَتَقَبَّلُ عَنْهُمْ أَحْسَنَ مَا أَمِلُوا وَنَتَجَابَزُ عَنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ فِي أَصْحَابِ الْجَنَّةِ وَعْدَ الصِّدْقِ الَّذِي كَانُوا يُعَدُونَ. They are the people, from them we accept the best of their deed, and we remove from them their mistakes and their sins. They are among the people of Jannah, and that is a promise, a truthful promise, which they have been promised. That is about those people who are trustworthy and true in their saying. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised them a true promise as well. Let us take this ayah in which the word barr is used in Al-Quran from Surah At-Tur. وَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ قَالُوا إِنَّا كُنَّا قَبْلُ فِي أَهْلِنَا مُشْفِقِينَ فَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا وَوَقَانَا عَذَابَ السَّمُومِ إِنَّا كُنَّا مِنْ قَبْلُ نَدْعُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْبَرُّ الرَّحِيمُ. That is what is going to happen on the Day of Judgment. They, any people, a group of the people who entered into Al-Jannah, they are saying to each other. They start asking each other. They said, in the past we were very, very fearful about our family, what is going to happen to them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has showed a favor to us and He saved us. He saved us from a scorching fire. Inna kunna min qablu nad'uuh. We used to invoke His name. We used to call Him before that. Innahu huwa al-barru rahim. Indeed, He is righteous. He is merciful. Now this word birr, which we said means the righteousness. All the different types of righteousness or good deeds are mentioned in this beautiful ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah. ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين وآتى المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا وأولئك هم المتقون. The righteousness is not that you just turn your faces toward the east and the west, but the real righteousness is of that person who believes in Allah, the last day, the angels, the book and the prophets. And He gives money. Though He loves that money, He gives it to those who are related to Him, to the orphans, to the poor, to the travelers, to those who ask for it, and to set the slave free. And then He establishes the prayer. He gives zakat. Those people who fulfill their covenants, their promises, and those people who show patience in poverty, when they are afflicted with any trouble and at the time of battle. Ulaika alladhina sadaqu, they are the truthful people. Wa ulaika humul muttaqun, and they are al muttaqun, those who fear Allah. That was what we could say about Al-Barr. Now let us move to the next attribute of Allah, which is At-Tawwaab. At-Tawwaab, the acceptor of repentance. As you know that this word is coming from Taba, Yatubu. Taba means to return. The man, when he returns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after committing a mistake or sin, he is known as At-Ta'ib. And when he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this repentance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts that attitude of the man. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a tawwab. He returns upon the man with the acceptance of tawbah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so generous that He himself teaches the person how to repent. Just look at the case of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. He committed a mistake, he and his wife, when they ate from the prohibited tree in Al-Jannah. Now when they have shown the regret, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught them how to say the words of repentance. فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Adam received words of repentance from Allah. He set them. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who accepts the repentance, and He is merciful. And that surah, that short surah, which is known as Surah An-Nasr, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَصَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. The word tawwab is used in this surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, when, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the victory and conquest come from Allah, and you see the people entering into the deen of Allah in groups after groups, then celebrate the praises of your Lord and ask His forgiveness. إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. Indeed, He is the one who accepts the repentance. So that repentance which is needed here, that is demanded from each and every Muslim. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. All of you turn back to Allah so that you receive the success, al-falah, the success, all of you. That is the commandment by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what type of repentance? That repentance which is known as tawbatan nasuha, as mentioned in Surah At-Tahrim. يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا عسى ربكم أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار يوم لا يخزي الله النبي والذين آمنوا معه نورهم يسعى بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم يقولون ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. O believer, turn back to Allah with a sincere tawbah, with a sincere repentance. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أصار ربكم أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove from you your sins and let you enter into gardens underneath which the rivers flow. That day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to disgrace His Prophet and those who believed with Him, their light would be flowing before them and on their right. And they would be saying to Allah, O our Rabb, complete for us our light and forgive us. Indeed, You are able upon everything. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us tawfiq, ability to acquire such type of tawbah, all of us. And inshallah, we are going to continue with two more attributes of Allah after the break. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الله الرحمن الرحيم المالك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار.
Many people trying to get together, but all their efforts were in vain because of ignoring or turning away from this great foundation. We see many people coming to the way of truth, following the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but later on, they get off track. What is the reason behind that? Unity is a result, it's not a cover-up. We have to be united from inside. And Allah made this clear in the Quran when He said, وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولَ.
الله الرحمن الرحيم المالك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have just spoken about two attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Barr and At-Tawwaab, before the break. Now let us take Al-Muntaqim, the Avenger, the owner of retribution, and Al-Afuww, the pardoner, the forgiver. And they are in our order, number 81 and 82. Al-Muntaqim, which is coming from intaqama, the Arabic word intaqama, to avenge, to take the vengeance. Now this attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Muntaqim, shows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He comes to punish some people, especially those people who have rejected Allah Himself, who have rejected His messengers, who have rejected His guidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala got a sunnah, and that sunnah is to give them respite. He is not going to destroy a people at once after the disobedience, no. As we are going to discuss later, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is as-sabur as well. He got patience. So He gives the time to people to reflect, to correct themselves, to amend themselves. And if they don't do that, if they don't repent, if they don't come back to Allah, then eventually they receive that punishment. So al-intiqam is to inflict the most severe punishment upon the criminals. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in this ayah. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ ذُكِّرَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ ثُمَّ أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا إِنَّا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُنْتَقِبُونَ. Who is more tyrant, more unjust than that person who was admonished with the signs of Allah, with the ayat of Allah, and then he just did not pay heed to them. Indeed, we are going to take revenge from the criminals. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how the people have treated him. He said, فَإِمَّا نَذْحَبَنَّ بِكَ فَإِنَّا مِنْهُمْ مُنْتَقِمُونَ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we have taken you, means out from the town, and you have to leave the town because of the rejection by the people, and then فَإِنَّا مِنْهُمْ مُنْتَقِبُونَ, then we are going to take vengeance from those people. This is again another sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah is not going to punish some people as long as the messenger is with them. The messenger becomes a source of their safety and security as long as he is with them. But at a certain point, when he was told to leave the people and leave that place, for example, then and only then the people are going to be punished by Allah. So we have seen all the other prophets of Allah, especially the messengers of Allah, like Nuh alayhi salam. He did not leave his people, but his migration or hijrah was in the form of moving from one place to the boat which he erected. And once he was in the boat, and of course, as we know that the people were punished by the floods, so his people were destroyed. In the same way, you can say about all other messengers of Allah. So this ayah is telling us, فَإِمَّا نَذْحَبَنَّ بِكْ, if we have taken you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِنَّا مِنْهُمْ مُنْتَقِبُونَ, then we are going to take revenge from them. And that is the very same sunnah which is mentioned in this ayah. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to punish them as long as you are there, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are in them, among them. And another thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to punish them as long as they are seeking istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That shows that during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet himself was a source of peace and security for the people of Makkah. And when he left Makkah, and that is again by the permission of Allah, when he left Makkah and he migrated to Al-Madina, now that peace and security was taken away from the people of Makkah. After our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this sunnah is in this way, that as long as the people are seeking forgiveness from Allah, they are doing istighfar, they are not going to be punished. But if with their disobedience, they are not even seeking istighfar from Allah, they are not repenting, they are not coming back to the good deeds, then that peace and security is not secured for them and they may be destroyed. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in these ayat, that has happened. The people of Makkah who rejected the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what happened to them in the battle of Badr? All their famous leaders, they were all perished, destroyed in the battle of Badr. Even the person like Abu Lahab, the real uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was left in Makkah, who did not come for the battle, he even died a terrible death in Makkah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Muntaqim. And then take the opposite character or attributes of Allah, that is Al-Afuww. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the forgiver, is the pardoner. The word Al-Afuww, which is coming from Afa, Afa means to erase something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has given or who has managed to have our records, of course the angels are appointed with each and every person, two angels who are recording whatever you do, whatever you utter. So that record which is prepared by the messengers of Allah, messengers here it means the angels, who can erase that mistake or that sin which is recorded there? No one. Is it possible for a human being to erase something from that record? No, it is not possible. Who can do that? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَمْحُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيُثْبِتُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes, erases what he likes, and he keeps what he likes. That is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now there are three terms which are used in Al-Quran in one ayah, for example. That ayah which says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ وَأَوْلَادِكُمْ عَدُوًا لَكُمْ فَاحْذَرُوهُمْ وَإِنْ تَعْفُوا وَتَصْفَهُوا وَتَغْفِرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Three terms are used here. First of all, the meaning of the ayah, O believers, some of your members of your family, like your wives, your children, they are enemies to you. فَحْذَرُوهُمْ, be careful about them. But if you got al-afw and as-safh and al-maghfira, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor, he is forgiving, he is merciful. So what are these three terms? Al-afwa. Al-af, that is the first term. That the person deserves punishment, deserves disciplining, but you just leave him, leave that punishment. As-safh, that is more than that. Al-i'raad anil mudhnib. That even you don't come to that person and don't say any words of blame to him. You don't hold him blameworthy. You just bypass him. That is al-irad, al-safh. And then the third attribute, that is al-ghafr, al-maghfira, which is to cover the sin. It must not be seen by the people. It should be covered completely. So here what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, that if you forgive and if you bypass them, don't take or don't do much attention to their sins, and you forgive them, that is better. Now this ayah was revealed in what context? It is said that some people who were in Mecca and they wanted to migrate just like all other Muslims who were migrating from Mecca to Medina during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When they wanted to do that, their own family members, their wives, their children, they stopped them from doing that. So this is how they delayed their migration. Eventually, when they came to Al-Madinah, and they were deep-rooted in Islam, they got all these teachings of Islam, which corrected them, amended their character, they thought that we have done wrong by delaying our migration. So this is why they wanted to punish their family members. Here these ayat were revealed, that though some of your family members, like your spouses, like your children, they are enemies to you, but forgive them. Forgive them. Try to cover their sins. So that is the meaning of this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the forgiver. And we as Muslims, we should try to absorb this character in ourselves by forgiving the people their mistakes. You may be hurt by their sayings, by their slanderings. But as someone has said that, make your chest a cemetery. Make your chest a graveyard. For what? To bury all such feelings of enmity, all such sayings which are going to hurt you or which have hurted you, bury them there. Don't speak about them. And one of the best dua which our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha to say in the night of power and dignity, and in each night you can say that, Allahumma innaka afoon تُحِبُّ الْعَفْوَ فَعْفُ أَنِّي. O Allah, you are forgiver. You love forgiving, so forgive me. And with this, we come to the end of this episode. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allahu Rahmanu Rahimu الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار الله 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 الرحمن الرحيم الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار